So for more, we now welcome Rabbi Shlomo Katz from the Shirat David Synagogue, and he joins us from Efrat. Rabbi, thank you so much for speaking to us on this National Day of Mourning in Israel. So to start, you were on your way to Mount Meron at the time of this tragedy. Take us back, if you will, to the moment you heard what had happened and what unfolded next.
Good evening. We were about 20, 25 minutes away, 25 minutes south of Meron, a little van, a minibus, about 20 of us. And people started dozing off, but there was a lot of excitement, a lot of excitement. And one of my close friends kind of just tugged me on my shoulder, and he's like, I don't think we're making it to Meron this year. What are you talking about? And there was the initial report, something happened. Couldn't figure out what it was. But as we chose to veer off the highway and stop at a gas station, we saw hundreds of other buses, cars, and vans of people. They were also making their way. Men, women, a lot of children. We were all caught in the unknown with many, many different conflicting reports, as to what was actually happening over there. This is about 2 a.m. And as much as it's also a big blur, I also more or less remember every second from that moment on, because it's as if our lives were before Meron, and now they're going to be after Meron.
And Rabbi, to that exact point, you have been in contact with relatives who have lost loved ones, all of whom had gone to celebrate Lag BaOmer, such a time of celebration. Usually, one can only imagine the panic and the shock that people were experiencing in the early hours of Friday morning. What more can you share with us today?
It was exactly that. It was shock and disbelief, and also fear of the unknown, which unfortunately, the known became our greatest fears and our worst dreams actually happening. For the rest of that morning, really until a few minutes before Shabbat came in, people were still unsure of their loved ones that have not been contacted and did not make contact with them. One of our dear friends here in the community are the aunt and uncle of a very precious 19-year-old boy who will be laid to rest in just a few hours in Jerusalem, Donnie Morris. And I had this very, very unfortunate privilege. I call it an unfortunate privilege, but being with someone in moments like this, you live life differently afterwards. I was with them when they had to go to Abu Kabir when the call came in to come and identify the body. And what I saw there, what we experienced there, is something that I really bless everyone in the world to never, ever have to go through. And that is a frenzy of people, a total state of chaos. It's Friday afternoon, tons of different families with so many questions, but with that same look in that eye, that look of absolute disbelief and fear, but still holding on to some thread of hope that maybe it's a mistake, maybe it's not their loved one. And when you see people like that, when you look in those kind of eyes, you can't continue living the same. Life is different. Sensitivity is different. Communication is different. So that's really where we're still at. All of us here as a collective community here in Efrat, as we've all just been hugging each other as tight as we can.
And Rabbi, thank you so much for sharing that. I can hear how deeply personal this is. We are also hearing that there are reports of secular communities in Tel Aviv queuing to donate blood, an Arab community in the north setting up food tables for those nearby. We know that tragedies can unite people. Israel knows this all too well. But still, there are some serious questions that people will be asking as to how this could have happened. What message do you have very briefly for people who really are battling to process what is going on right now? Very briefly, if you don't mind.
I don't mind, and I think you actually answered my answer by focusing on the first part of your question. When we found out that there are discotheques and clubs that have been waiting a whole year due to the coronavirus, that have been planning some massive parties on Friday night, and these are discotheques in Tel Aviv that have decided to shut down in solidarity with their brethren that don't look anything like them, and the fact that the lines for donating blood We're going for miles and miles on Friday afternoon.
Right.
Zeha Am Shali. That's my people. That's our people. That's who we really, really, really are. And I'm just going to hold on to that for dear life.
Well, we really thank you so much, Rabbi Shlomo Katz, speaking to us on this very difficult day, a national day of mourning in Israel. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.